So actually, I thought of an idea for this. So we know that there are, for instance, 12 months. So if we can first group these cards by month, so all those people born in January, all those people born in February, and so on, then when we look for the same birthday, we only have to look within the same month. We don't have to look across months. So by first separating
it out. Because we saw that, you know, the number of cards, when we did this, the number of cards in each month was like six, seven,
yeah,
not too many.
Yeah, because maybe there are only 30 altogether, and yeah, there are 12 months, so there should not be too
many.
So
what you're saying is that when we want to compare, it doesn't make sense to compare a December with a March.
Yeah.
That's what you're doing anyway.
Exactly. Each time we are doing that, whereas if we had
separated out.
To begin
so
with.
So what are you suggesting we do? We separate the cards into bins.
Into bins, yeah.
So bins by month.
Month of.
Which means you'll get 12 bins.
You'll get 12 bins. And then we just have to individually
bins.
Do this.
You could similarly do with date, but that would give you 31 bins.
Yeah, correct.
Right.
And
now you're doing, so but now you're doing month, which is seems more sensible thing to do. So you got 12 bins. So we separate the cards into 12 bins. And then you're saying?
In each bin, we have to compare
compare cards with everything else. But since the number is very small,
it will be
six or seven, it will be much faster.
Yeah. So if we do it systematically, we have to do it again like a nested iteration, but it will only be few cards, five cards or something. So it will be 5 into 4, maybe 10 comparisons per bin. So the total number of things will be much less than doing this 400 comparisons.
Interesting. How did that happen? I mean, suddenly we found it got reduced. So this is it. Huh? So because there is this natural categorization into months and days that we are using.
Yeah, so there are some natural groups and you expect the groups to be sort of equally
distributed.
Because everybody is born in December, then doesn't help. But you all know that you have only 30 days in December. So
you're expecting that the group, so basically if you divide it into 10 bins or 12 bins or number of bins, you expect that the number of cards are somewhat fairly equally distributed.
Exactly.
So the number of cards per bin comes down, and then this business of doing everything with everything, which is a product, right, you're doing, that becomes a lot easier. Very interesting. Let's try that.
Okay. So first do the binning. So we will just create. So we have to have six. So we know. So let's put it in order of months. So December, let's keep it here. March, let's keep it there. Just roughly keeping the place according to the thing.
So if you take four per row, three rows.
Okay.
So Jan, Feb, March, April, right?
Okay.
So March, so something comes here.
So
this will be April.
Yeah. So let us keep. Okay, maybe we'll see. Okay, so December goes with December.
Okay.
March goes with March. September is a new bin. September. June comes somewhere in between. July is here. March goes with March. July. November comes near December. November. April we don't have yet, so let's keep it next to that. January. January. September we have a bin. December we have a bin. May, let's keep it here. October we don't have a bin yet. May, March, December, May, August, we don't have a bin. So let's keep it. So May, June, July, August, let's keep it there. Then February, May, and October. Right. So we actually
kind
have
of distributed. Huh?
Yeah, we actually have at least one in each bin. Yeah. And now what we need to do is then
go one by one.
One by one, right? So we start with say January.
And do the same thing.
Do the same thing. So we will say try Srinidhi. So 14 January, 4th is not there, 12th is not there. So this is out. Then we compare these two and now we are done. So January
That's
is done.
Fast, huh? Really
so
fast.
January is done. So January. We can maybe turn it over to say it is done. Now February we have only two and they are different.
Okay.
So we don't lose anything. And in this case, we know that the answer comes in March, so we'll actually find it fast. 15th, so we have found in March, but these two are different, right? So we have, maybe we can keep these aside for now. But now we can also do this, what we said before. Are there any other pairs?
Find all the pairs.
Yeah. So
that's really cool. Yeah.
So April, there's only one, so can't be April. So now we have to do, May has a lot, so we first do it systematically. So May, so we have to compare for 13th, so it is not 5, it is not 6, it is not 16, so this is out. So we can actually do it by inspection, but we have to do it systematically. For 16, we say it's not 6, not 5, so 16 is out. Then 5 and 6 are different, so these are different, so May is out.
Right? This is fast.
June,
only one.
July, again, we have a few, so 23rd July, it's not 17, not 22nd, and 17 and 22nd are also different from each other. So this is out. August only 1. September, check 22, check 10. So it's not 17, and it's not 22, and it's not 10. October only 2, they are not equal to each other. November only 2, they are not equal to each other. December, there are a few, but again, you can check them. So 30th, it's not 26, not 6, not 14, so it's not 30th. 14 is not 6, not 26, so it's not 14, and then 6 is not 20. So all these are different. So we're done. So actually now in much less time,
right? Noticeably less time, and you'll not make mistakes. You know, the other thing is that when you go through like this, it makes it, the mistakes also get reduced, isn't it?
Yeah. So actually, binning helped. Yeah, but we have to be a bit careful because binning, of course, we need not help. For instance, there are 30 cards. They could have been
all December.
Yeah, all December, all on different days.
Oh, yeah, it could be. Yeah.
Then we would have still had to do one
but
by one.
But one expects. I mean, so you have to choose, you have to basically choose the binning method in such a way that it kind of distributes the cards across the days. Then it makes, right? Then it starts to make sense. Yeah.
So for instance, if it is that and we have chosen the date to bin, then we would have got 30 bins with one date each, and we would have known that there are no two.
Correct.
Right? Yeah. So sometimes looking at the data gives you a clue as to what would be a simpler way of organizing it.
Right.
But essentially here, we did this one pass to do the binning, and then we did several very small passes to do the actual selection. And
that one pass through the bin is a single iteration.
It's one single
and iteration. The several small passes.
They are all technically
nested iterations,
but
technically,
with much smaller,
but smaller sets.
And some of them were only one or two. So essentially, there was no iteration; just one comparison was enough.
Yeah.
And so for these numbers, at least this worked much better. But this could also dramatically cut down the time if we have a larger set.
Correct.
Yeah. So it's useful to think a little bit before blindly
just jumping into
a problem
and solving it, right?
Okay. Mm.